Ah, yes, the Glock 17L. I bought this gun roughly about 5 years ago, and when I did that, I had no intention of turning it into a Nintendo Zapper, as you can see here. Overall, though, I am relatively satisfied with what it's become. So let's take a few shots with it, shall we? The barrel length is, from what I understand from Glock's website, is 6.02 inches, relatively larger than a standard Glock, obviously. The advantages, it does have a longer sight radius, which is much nicer. Honestly, it's just overall a relatively cool gun. It's not something everyone has. Being that Glock only makes them in limited runs, I do recommend getting one if you do have the opportunity. One thing that you do hear a lot is that Glocks never jam. Well, here I'm trying to prove that by shooting it one hand with relatively a loose grip. However, as you can see, it didn't work. So, maybe that's true. So in order for my 17L to become a Nintendo Zapper, first I had to get it cerakoted, obviously. So after looking at one of the Zappers, I determined that the slide would receive the steel gray coating. The frame would be tactical gray, the mag catch and the slide catch crimson, so then the other components such as the trigger, the slide plate, and the trigger retaining pins, I had to find some that were already anodized red. Well, spoke too soon. Interesting note on that, when that particular stovepipe happened, I racked the slide and you could see a live cartridge being extracted as well. Honestly, that's the first time that's ever occurred. I don't know, just maybe a fluke. But I'll definitely have a Glock armor, take a look and see if maybe I need to replace the recoil spring. I doubt it, but you never know. This is only at 7 yards. What I'm doing here is trying to make the Big Dipper. However, it's not turning out too well. As I said, I'm not a professional marksman. Here I'm trying to make a nice group as well, but it seems to be I'm trying to impress Martin Riggs. I think he'd like it. Now, when I've demonstrated how a semi-automatic handgun works, I usually dry fire the gun, rack the slide, and then let the trigger reset. And I'm asked, do you do that every single time? You can, but in this case it turns a 17-round magazine into an 8-round magazine. As you see here, I can rack the slide each time, but a live cartridge is being extracted. So, I don't recommend that. An interesting note on the Glock 17L is when you're shooting it, it does feel quite a bit different compared to other Glock pistols, and that is due to the much longer slide barrel. Now, of course, the 17L is the largest 9mm they produce, whereas there is the long slide 10mm of the Glock Model 40. This is a very smooth shooting pistol, and between this and the CZ75 I've shot these the most. That being said, this gun only has about 2,500 rounds through it, which is relatively low in the 5 years I've had it. And the CZ75 has had maybe 1,500 rounds through it. You know, as I said, not very high round counts. I've only shot the Glock 17, 19, 20, 21, 22, 26, 17L, of course, and the 48. I would like to shoot the new model 44 and 22 just to say I have. I do want to shoot the Glock 18, that's the select fire version of the 17. However, I would want it outfitted with a stock so I could better control the recoil. Well, I want to shoot it both ways. But I'm sure I have a much higher chance of shooting the Glock Model 7 that was built in Germany, that's made out of porcelain and can't be detected by airport metal detectors. You never know though. Yippee-ki-yay, melon farmer. Overall good grouping, and I also pierced the ears of this target. On that note, I remember someone asking about the Glock Model 400. Of course, when I heard that, my first thought was, is that in 40 or 50 watt range? I had forgotten that there was such thing as a Glock which can be converted into, I believe it's the 400 Cor-Bon. So here, as you're gonna see, I'm just going to change magazines and use the slide catch as a release. That's a long-standing debate on whether or not to use it as a release or a catch. That really boils down to you. But here, as you can see, I compared it by just running the slide. Normally that's what I do, but there are times I have used a slide catch, I'm not gonna lie. Let's take this firearm apart real quick, shall we? First thing, of course, make sure the gun is unloaded, drop the magazine, rack the slide. In a safe direction, dry fire it. Pull back ever so slightly on the slide. pull down on these two tabs, and then push the slide forward. Being a Gen 3, it does have a captured recoil spring. Gens 4 and 5 have a dual recoil spring system, as do the models 26 and 27. As with most pistols, lift up on the barrel, move it slightly forward, and pull it to the rear once it clears the breech face. Not too bad, it was only 50 rounds after all. Like the CZ, when field stripped, there's not many components. Honestly, I was gonna leave this gun just stock black, but I decided why not change it over time. So let's reassemble this firearm now. Insert the barrel, make sure it's seated properly, like so. Take the recoil spring, this end always goes into the front of the slide. Line up your slide and rails. There's no need to rush reassembling the slide if you do jump the rails. It is a pain to remove that to where you can actually assemble it correctly. So just take your time on that part. Now rack the slide, dry fire in a safe direction, hold the trigger, rack the slide again, then listen for your reset, then dry fire it again. Now take an empty magazine, insert it, rack the slide to make sure it does lock open, drop the magazine, run the slide, and dry fire again. How about we punch some more paper? So if Glock does decide to produce this in the Generation 5, I more than likely will be buying one. I haven't had the chance to shoot the Model 34, and the only reason, at least from what I understand, the reason for the Model 34 being introduced was the Model 17L was a little bit too large to be used in competition. If I remember correctly, there's a box which the firearm has to fit in, and the 17L is too long, hence the Model 34. Anyway, as always, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, consider subscribing. Click on that bell icon so you're notified when I upload new videos. Leave your comments in the section below. I do enjoy those, and have a good day. See ya!